All right, the first thing I need for you to do is on a new piece of paper in your spiral, write down your assignment title. What's it going to be?
Unit 1,
Early Man. So go ahead and write that. Unit 1, Early Man. Sure, I would, in case that paper would tear out. Okay, what's the very first thing I told you yesterday and the day before that we always write when we start something?
The standard.
Okay, so I've set up a page here for you so you can kind of see what it looks like. You may be on the right or the left piece of paper, it doesn't matter, okay? So I'm going to put, and I forgot to put this on here, so I will right now. Here's Early Man. Okay. All right, here's the standard. I know you probably can't see that because it's tiny. So it's right here. Okay. So you're writing the standard right now. If you can't see it, you can move up here to the front where you can. But write the standard. Identify sites in Africa where archaeologists and historians have found evidence of the origins of modern human beings and describe what the archaeologists found. All right, so you have your standard written. So we're moving on to the next slide. Now, there's several videos you're going to be watching today, okay? So if you want to move to the front, you can. All right, first thing that we want to do is I want you to circle the word Africa in your standard. You can use your orange pen if you want to, your orange marker. Circle Africa. Underline archaeologists. Underline historians. And underline modern. Okay, so we've circled Africa, underline archaeologists, underline historians, underline modern. And go ahead and circle origins. See it? Origins, it's in your standard. All right, now, first word you're going to write down on your notes, underneath your standard for your notes, is the word archaeologist. Archaeologist. Okay, write that word down right now. Archaeologist. Skip a couple lines, write archaeologist. We have two definitions that you get to choose from. We have Webster's definition, and we have Wills's definition. So you get to choose which one you want to write. Webster defines an archaeologist, whoops, I spelled that wrong, as the scientific study of material remains as fossil relics, artifacts, and monuments of past human life and activities. Wills says, basically, an archaeologist is a person who studies human history by digging up human remains and artifacts. Which one do you want to use?
Yours.
Mine? Okay, I want you to write down the definition that I have. A person who studies human history by digging up human remains and artifacts. Okay, so, if an archaeologist is a person who studies human history by digging up human remains, what's human remains? What do you think? What do you think, Malik?
Bones.
There you go. Bones. Okay, so human remains would be bones. Is it possible if someone has been buried for thousands of years for them to still have their skin on their body?
No.
Who says no? Mm-hmm. Who says yes? Who's not sure?
It is possible.
Think about the mummies.
Yeah.
Their skin's still on them, right?
They wrap them up.
Okay, because they wrap them up, right? But their skin is still there. Okay, so it's possible. It depends on where the human remains are found. If it's really dry, really wet, really cold. If it's a really, really cold area, the tundra. What's the tundra? What is it?
Antarctica.
Yeah. Is it snowy and cold or is it dry and hot?
It's snowy and cold.
Do you think that if there were human remains under all that snow, that you would find anything?
Yes.
Who says yes? Who says no? The answer is yes. Because there's a story about a man named Otzi who they found in the ice. And when he even still had all of his clothes, they could figure out what his clothes were made of. It's a pretty crazy story. Maybe you'll get to read it, okay? All right, so, yes, you can find more than bones. All right, what's a human artifact? Wait.
Like...
Give me a hint.
Bones. Earrings.
And?
Rings.
Jewelry, right?
Or bases.
Girls, you wear jewelry, right? Can that be found years from now? Mm-hmm. What about these?
Glasses,
you think so?
Yeah.
They might be broken or bent, but you can find them, right? What about, what do you eat out of when you get home?
Forks.
And spoons.
And knives.
Forks and spoons and knives.
And plates.
And plates. And bowls.
Fork.
Okay, and
cups.
Okay, so can they find what you eat out of?
Yes.
What's something else? It's an artifact. Okay, like football helmet. What else?
They can find, like, their cake and smash up their berries.
Okay, what they use to grind their berries upon. Yes. What do you think, Jess?
Mine feels a little bit of henna. They use kind of like a spear thing to get food, as if they got a wee bit smarter.
Okay.
And I'm probably thinking someone could probably find that, but I might be, like, snacking down.
So, weapons? Mm-hmm. Okay, let me ask you this question. How many of you know someone has a farm, and you've been on their farm before? Have you ever found an arrowhead on a farm before?
Yes.
Have you ever found anything from the Civil War on a farm before?
No.
Yeah. Is that a human remain or a human artifact?
That's an artifact,
right? Okay. So the human artifacts are the things that the humans used. Okay. All right. Let's go to the next one. So now we know what an archaeologist does. They dig in the dirt, right? Do they always have to dig in the dirt?
No. You can just find them.
Is there an example of something really big that they did not have to dig for? Big hint right here. What do you think?
Pyramids.
The pyramids. Yes. What else?
Stonehenge.
What else?
That one thing in ancient Egypt, not the pyramids, but the
with the
dog thing.
The half body of a cat.
Yeah.
The Sphinx. Okay. What's the picture up there on Rome?
Hey, the Colosseum.
The Colosseum. Do you know another one?
There's caveman's drawings.
Caveman's drawings. What else? Okay. The Leaning Tower of Pisa.
Mayan temples.
The Mayan temples. Right. The Mayan temples and the ziggurat. Okay. So you don't always have to dig to find them. All right. Now we're going to watch a video. If you can't see, you're welcome to move up here to the front. Just sit on the floor. Okay. So anybody want to move up? Going once, going twice, third time's charm. Okay, here we go. As soon as I click this slide, it's going to start playing, okay?
Due to technical difficulties, we are starting the video over.
What is archaeology? Alashmuk. Like, what is it? Really? Think about all the stuff you have. All the stuff you throw away. Everything you can see and touch. Without getting into trouble, that is. Now, imagine you're suddenly gone. Forever. All your stuff is left behind. Oh, and 2,000 years have passed. And your brother is probably called dibs on everything by now.
Dibs!
So, what still exists? Your banana peels and tissue boxes have decomposed. So has Uncle Ernie.
Sup, dude.
What about less perishable stuff? Your headphones, your computer keyboard, that underwear your parents gave you last year when they forgot it was your birthday? Based on the stuff you left behind, what could someone understand about you? Assuming they didn't have access to your diary, and that would be cheating. Besides, they'll never figure out where you hid the key. Okay, this is the essence of archaeology. It's all the stuff you left behind. Archaeologists study the people and cultures of the past, be it 20 years ago or 200,000. Although, they tend to find more fossils from the 200,000 years ago type. If they uncover remains from 20 years ago, it probably warrants a friendly call to the local police station.
Rosebud.
The process of digging up various old junk is called excavation. Archaeologists excavate to dig up artifacts, which is basically anything that's been hidden below the surface for years. Could be your sister's diary, could be a metallic cylinder from the Byzantine era, but digging isn't all archaeologists do. If that were the case, their biceps would be ridiculous like this guy. They also study stuff that doesn't need to be excavated, like the pyramids, the Roman Colosseum, or those cool bronze statues they haul out of the sea once in a while.
Can I get a towel?
Okay, now we know what archaeology is, but why in the world is it important? Can't we just let the past remain in the past? Are we really going to solve any pressing modern problems by knowing what the ancient Egyptians used to brush their teeth? Believe it or not, the stuff we've unearthed has given us a better understanding of who we are today, not just who we used to be. By examining where we started and comparing it to where we are today, we can piece together patterns of human progress, as well as figure out where we might be going wrong.
Ugh, look at her hair!
It's sort of like there's this vast world history book buried in the ground, and archaeologists are in charge of putting it back together page by page. But it's even more extensive than a regular world history book, because it allows us to learn about things that predate written history.
That'll never work.
Plenty of fascinating stuff happened thousands of years ago, even if no one could tweet about it. Archaeology has helped us to understand ancient religions,
chick meat,
the daily routines of various cultures, how military weaponry has evolved over time, and oh so much more. It also serves as a fantastic backdrop for epic adventure movies. Ooh.
All right, so that tells you a little bit more about archaeologists, right? In a fun video. Mm-hmm. All right, let's move to the next one. So now on your standard, can you check off that you know what an archaeologist is? Yeah. Absolutely, so put a check mark over it. I didn't notice that. All right, so the next word you're going to write down is historian. Okay, so word number two, historian. So let's write that one down. Okay, we have two definitions we can choose from. Webster, who says a historian is a student or writer of history, especially one who produces a scholarly synthesis. History is the study of past events. Or we can go with Wills's. Basically, a historian is a person who studies events that happened in the past. What do you want to use? All right, let's write this one. A historian is a person who studies events that happened in the past. So if a historian is a person who studies the events that happened in the past, what do your history books contain? Malik?
The same thing.
They contain events that what way?
Happened before or after written
records. Yeah, happened after written records, and it happened in the present or the
past. Future.
The past. It happened in the past. That's what I call it, history. It happened in the past. Okay? So a historian is someone who studies that stuff. All right, look back there at our topics again in the back of the room. We're starting with what's our first big unit?
Early man.
And we're going to make our way all the way to what?
Rome.
To Rome. Are we going to be studying events that happened in the past?
Yes.
Yes. So can we ourselves consider ourselves historians? Yeah, so when you come in this room this year, I want you to consider yourself a historian. You are someone now who is going to be studying events that happened in the past. And when I say the past in this classroom, it's the way past. Okay? All right, let's see what our next slot is. It's a video. All right, so if you want to move up front, come on. Okay, pay attention to what you see in this video. Look for things familiar. It'll start moving fast here in a minute.
Bye.
next word. Okay, so let's write our next word down. This one is short and sweet. Modern. Okay? Modern. Now, before you write the definition for modern, you already have a check mark over your archaeologist. Can you now tell me what a historian does? What do they do? Tell me.
They study about the past.
They study about the past. All right, so now we're going to talk about modern. Okay, so write the word modern down. Modern. Is modern the past or the present? It's present. So what you're going to write down is when we talk about the present time, we are talking about modern. So right here's your definition for modern. Present time. So I got to write. Modern. Present time. Write that down. Okay. So the next thing we're going to do now is we are going to pull down these boxes to something if it's modern or something if it comes from the past. Now, on the video, for those of you that are home watching the video, we're going to play this game. You can play this game, but you're going to have to kind of just figure out yourself whether this was past or modern. Okay? Okay, so if you were in class today, you just got to play this game where we did modern or past artifacts. So we're going to move on now to the next slide. All right, the next slide. It says now we know what an archaeologist is. What is it? Raise your hand if you know. Raise your hand if you know. Raise your hand if you know. Tell me what it is. Yeah. Person who digs up stuff, sometimes they don't have to dig. What are they looking for? Artifacts or
bones.
Human remains, right? Okay, a historian. Raise your hand if you know what it is. What is it? They study the past. Perfect. Modern. Tell me. Present time. Okay, so our standard that we have. It says, so what is this standard actually asking us to do? Well, there's a verb that starts out this standard, this one right here. What is that?
Identify.
If you identify something, what do? Malik?
You check over it.
You check over it, you
find
it. If I say, identify your coloring pencils, you would go, chink, and point to it. If I say, identify the textbook on your table, you would point to it, right? You identify it. So when you identify, you tell me or you show me what something is, okay? So the standard says, identify a site in where?
Africa.
In Africa, where archaeologists and historians found what?
Remains.
Remains of what?
Human.
Human remains. Okay, what does it mean if you have evidence? Tell me, Wade.
No.
Okay, let me give you an example.
Like if somebody, like murder mysteries, like you have evidence.
Okay, that's perfect. Let me give you for example. At home right now on my farm, I have a miniature horse. It's purple with pink polka dots.
Really?
Who believes me?
Me.
Really? All right, how can I prove that to you?
Bring a picture in.
I can provide evidence. How can I provide evidence? Tell me one
picture.
Way. A picture. Tell me another way.
Video. Wait, no, because she can Photoshop it.
But on the internet, can I, like, just look up a polka dot horse? Yeah. So what's another way, please?
Filter
a video.
A video.
Filter to your
All right, in order for you to know that video is truly my horse, who needs to be in the video with it?
You.
Me. What if I loaded up the miniature horse on the trailer and brought it out here to the front yard? Would that be the best way to use it?
Yeah, it would be.
So providing evidence is like providing proof to you. Okay? All right, so we're going to provide evidence of the origin. What does origin mean? Tell me what it means, Miguel.
The beginning.
How something was created. The origin of modern human beings and describe. When you describe something, what do?
You, like, explain.
You explain. You tell me all about it. So if I were to tell you, explain or describe to me what that light looks like, you would say it is
round.
It is pink and right? Okay. It's standing on how many legs?
Four.
Does it run by a candle or is it electrical?
Electrical.
It's electrical, okay? So you described that light to me. All right, let's move on to the next one now. So you're going to describe to me, you're going to identify where origins were found of humans, and you're going to provide evidence, proof, that it was there. Okay? All right, video. Come on up if you want to. The first human remains, or at least a human ancestor remains, that they found were in Africa. They're going to show you the actual bones. They named her Lucy.
Wow.
Okay? I want you to listen to why they named her Lucy. Okay? All right, and I want you to pay attention. You're going to notice that you're going to recognize this guy in this video. Okay, here we go.
Darwin's theory of evolution changed everything. His assertion that humans evolved from ancient ancestors in Africa challenged traditional religious beliefs and motivated scientists of many disciplines to begin exploring the theory. It's one thing to claim that humans evolved from African apes. It would be another thing to prove it. In 1974, anthropologist Donald Johanson and his team were working in Ethiopia when they came upon the partial remains of an ancient hominid, a species considered to be part of the family that includes humankind. Because the skeleton had once stood about 3 feet tall, Johanson believed it was that of a young female. He named her Lucy, after the Beatles song, Lucy in the Sky with Diamonds. Despite her fragmented remains, Lucy had remarkable secrets to share about her life.
Oh, wow. Does this fit?
No.
At the time of her discovery, the most complete hominid skeleton ever found was less than 100,000 years old. Lucy was an estimated 3.2 million years old. Dr. Ken Mowbray is an anthropologist with the American Museum of Natural History.
Yeah, Lucy really shook up the family tree, so to speak.
Well, why was she such a big deal?
She was a big deal for many reasons. First of all, her skeleton was 40%
complete. 40% that's
complete
to you guys?
You know, in fossil terms, that's a lot of fossil bones for an individual. Something even more important that makes her really significant is that we believe that she was bipedal. I have a cast here of the pelvis of Lucy, the left side. The pelvis sits right like this in the human body. Mm-hmm. It is short and it is broad. If you were to look at a chimpanzee, a gorilla, or an orangutan, their blades are really narrow and really tall. The blade of Lucy, and like ours, extends outwardly. This allows the transference of weight if you were going to walk on two limbs. And so from this pelvis alone, we think that Lucy moved about the landscape as an habitual biped.
Like you and me.
Exactly. She was walking around essentially like us.
Lucy's discovery sparked a debate about whether she could be the long sought after missing link connecting apes with the first humans. But some anthropologists, like Dr. Mowbray, believe that the missing link is a myth. Now, for a long time, people thought there was a link between chimpanzees and humans. And when I look at chimpanzees and humans, I can see where you'd get that idea, but it's not that simple, right?
Absolutely. Lucy really opened up the world in the late 1970s to have a better understanding that there wasn't this linear progression of evolution, especially with humans, that it was much more diversified. With Lucy and subsequent fossil finds, we really know that this tree of life is much more like a bush. There's a lot of experimentation going on, a lot of dead ends.
Regardless of whose ancient footsteps we may be walking in, there's one remarkable set of footprints without dispute. In 1978, anthropologist Mary Leakey and her team were working in Laetoli, Tanzania, when they made one of the greatest discoveries in the study of human origins. A pair of fossilized footprints, old enough and small enough to have been made by two hominids, much like Lucy.
The significance is that, one, that they're dated at 3.6 million years ago. Those are the oldest human ancestor footprints that we have, that we know of today. More importantly, I think, it records behavior. Their footprints let us know that they were walking bipedally. There were no fingerprints, there were no knuckle marks around the imprints of their feet. And on top of that, we know that they were in groups. They were social. They weren't just walking by themselves.
The remarkable discovery of the Laetoli footprints was made possible by a series of natural events that occurred 3.7 million years ago.
Okay, listen to how this happened.
A volcano erupted, covering the landscape with a thin layer of ash. As rain fell, the ash became thick, like wet cement, and soon was covered by animal tracks, birds, a rabbit, and then the footprints of two hominids. Eventually, another volcanic eruption blanketed the spot with more ash, a protective layer that preserved the prints as they hardened. They remained hidden until Mary Leakey revealed them to the world.
Okay. Kind of cool, wasn't it? All right. That's another one. That's another skull of, I can't pronounce that name. Tomai, I think. Okay, all right. Stand up. Okay, let me back over that direction. All right, we're going to do something here. There's a couple of words that no one ever seems to know. Even last year they had trouble with this. All right, I'm going to ask you some questions. How many wheels does a bicycle have?
Three.
Two. Okay. How many wheels does a tricycle have? Drew.
Three.
So what does the prefix tri mean? Three. What does the prefix bi mean? What? Two. Okay, two. They said Lucy was bipedal. It looks like the word bipedal. All right, what is a pedestrian? What's a pedestrian? Tell me what pedestrian is.
Someone
who walks where they want to go. All right, so you take the word bi, which means two, and pedal, which is taken from the word pedestrian, and it must mean that you walk on
two
legs. Okay? Lucy walked on two legs. Now, how do monkeys and chimpanzees and apes and gorillas walk? On their legs and their knuckles, right? Okay, there's a reason for that. Okay, back up here. Let's spread out so you can all see because I'm going to have you do something. Okay, so back out where there's room. Okay, take your four fingers. Find these bones right here. You can feel them kind of sticking out. Feel them? Okay, feel those? All right, now take your thumbs. Thumbs are loose. Put them behind your back. All right, see where my thumbs are? All right, run your thumbs all the way over to your spine. Do you feel that bone?
Yeah.
Okay, do you know what bone that is? What bone is that you're feeling sticking out there? Your pelvis, okay? Now, if you paid attention to the video, There was something special about Lucy's pelvis bone. What was it?
It was short, but it was like wide.
It was short and wide. Okay? Your pelvis bone, they mirror each other. Okay? It kind of looks like Africa. Okay? Drew, point to me where Africa is. See how Africa is wide at the top?
That's weird.
And then it kind of is narrow and short at the bottom?
Yeah.
Okay. Your pelvis bone is that way in your hips right here. The reason that your pelvis bone is that way is, one, so it can hold the weight of your body, and two, so you can walk on
two legs.
Okay, now if you were listening, an ape or a gorilla, or a chimpanzee, or a monkey, they have a pelvis, but their pelvis is skinny and long. Can their pelvis support the weight of their body? Think about a gorilla.
No.
They're huge, right? Okay, so have you ever noticed, can a gorilla and a monkey and chimpanzee walk on two legs?
They can.
But yeah, but what does it look like?
A certain amount of
seconds. It looks like this, doesn't it? Okay? And they can only go for so far, and then what do they have to do?
Drop back down.
Drop back down on their knuckles, okay? It's because their pelvis is not the same shape. It will not support the weight of their body, and it will not allow them to walk upright like we do. They keep their hands over like this, and they just walk. Yeah, that's how they walk. All right, now, I want you to find a square on the floor in the room. You got to be away from people. You're too close. Y'all are too close to me. You're too close. Too close. Okay, find a square.
I found it. Okay. Is this a good square, ma'am?
No.
It's like right there.
No, you got to be able to move, okay? So stand on one square. Okay, that square is one square foot. Okay, so it's one foot. All right, so remember the square you're on. Take one foot and put it on the square in front of you. Nope, not 2 feet, 1 foot. 1 foot. Okay? So now your feet are in two squares, right? Okay, this is tricky. The same foot you just moved to that square. Move it to the next one.
Can I look on the square?
I hope not. You can't go sideways. You gotta go straight across. Okay, you can't go diagonal. Alright, now, you stand there on how many squares?
Two.
One, two,
three
squares, right? Okay, now you're gonna take that same foot again and only go halfway up the other square.
Oh, jeez.
Okay, turn around. Turn to the side where it's not so hard to stand on. Okay, do you see where your foot starts and where your foot ends?
Yeah.
Lucy was 3.5 feet tall. So she was as long as that first square to half of that next one.
How she's small.
Was she tall?
No, not really.
She wasn't really tall, was she?
So she, and she was 2 years old.
Right, okay, so she wasn't really tall. She only weighed about 60 pounds.
Oh, my.
So is there anybody here weighs 60 pounds?
I weigh
94. You weigh what? Anybody weigh 70? I weigh 75. Anybody weigh less than 60?
100%.
Okay. So you all already weigh more than Lucy did, right? She was just small. Okay, stand back up straight.
Oh, thank you.
Okay. Stand back up straight on the same square. All right. Now, you can walk on two legs. What's that called?
Bipedal.
Why are you bipedal? Raise your hand if you know. Because why way? You can walk on two legs, but why are you able to walk on two legs, Malik? Because you've the way your pelvis is shaped. Is your pelvis long and skinny or fat and short?
Fat and short.
Fat and short, okay? All right, go find your seat. We're going to move to the next thing. Right?
Yes, ma'am.
It has a map on it. Find it. Get that in front of you. First thing you're going to do is name, date, and class. Put it on there right now. Name, date, and class.
Class.
Will's 4. Okay? Because it's my class right now.
I can't
sit
in that
little box. You can just use the corner. Whatever you need to use. Today is the 12th. Yes. All right, you had a map on that paper of Africa, correct?
Yes,
ma'am. Lucy was found on the Horn of Africa. Okay, look over here at this map. Do you see this right here? Do you see how that kind of looks like a rhino's horn?
Yes.
Okay, they call that the Horn of Africa because it jets out like a horn. All righty? At the Horn of Africa, there is a place called Ethiopia. Find it on your map. Okay, do you see it?
Got it.
That is where Lucy was found.
All right? So, I want you to, on your map right now, draw a star with your pencil. Just your regular pencil. Draw a star on Ethiopia. Ethiopia is on the Horn of Africa. Now, if you are a local in Africa, that means you live there. So let me give you a for example. If we have people move from the north to Greenville, Tennessee, are they locals or are we locals?
We
are the locals because we live here. So the locals in Ethiopia do not call her Lucy, they call her Dinkanish. Dinkanish means unique. All right? Was Lucy a unique find?
Yes.
Yeah, she was. So they call her Dinkanish in Ethiopia. All right? Now, I'm going to place the star over where Lucy was found. Where was she found?
Ethiopia.
So right here, correct?
No.
Which way do I need to go? North, south, east, or west?
Northeast.
Northeast. There.
No.
Down.
Over
west. North, south, east, or west?
West.
West. Right there. Okay? So that's where Lucy, or what do the locals call her?
Dinkanish
was found. All right. Next thing. Okay? On your piece of paper, draw a line into your last note. Okay, I am going to play a song and put a timer on for 2 minutes. That's it, 2 minutes. Okay? How was Lucy given her name? Who heard that? They told you why she was named Lucy. Why was she named Lucy?
Song after the Beatles.
A song after the Beatles. Did anybody catch the name of that song?
Lucy.
What was it?
Lucy
in the Sky with Diamonds. Okay? Now, here's what you need. This is really hard. Whenever I've had to do this, I do a terrible job at it. So we'll see if you do a better job. Okay? I had some questions until I had to close the slide down. But on that piece of paper that you have left, I want you to write everything that you know about Lucy, about being bipedal, about an archaeologist, a historian, whatever. I want you to write. Don't stop for 2 straight minutes, okay? And while you're writing, I'm going to play Lucy in the Sky with Diamonds. Okay? All right. So I'm setting the time for 2 minutes. Okay, are you ready? On your mark, get set, go. Okay, here we go. All right, your paper in front of you. There is a textbook on your table. The instructions say read the section in your book entitled Human Discoveries on page 9. Turn to page 9. Quick. Page 9, just share. All right, you're going to share with a neighbor. So you and the neighbor team up. Okay? Page 9. Put your finger on the section called Human Discoveries. Human Discoveries on page 9. Okay. Now, Drew, will you read me just the first sentence?
In 1974, a team led by
paleontologist.
Donald Johansson made an exciting find in Ethiopia, Africa.
Okay, stop right there. Look at question number 1. In 1974, a team of what?
Paleontologists.
Write that in. Led by who?
Donald Johansson.
I think this is an O.
An
O-N, not an E-N. Okay. Donald Johansson made an exciting discovery in
Ethiopia.
Which
is in Africa.
Absolutely. Ethiopia, which is in Africa. Okay, you remember that orange pencil you have?
No, I'll
put it up. Okay, that orange pencil. It says number 2 here. On a map, color in orange, Ethiopia.
and place a star on it. Well, you've already put a star on it. So now you just need to color in Ethiopia. That's because, yeah, I don't know why. Now, half. Okay. All right. Wade keeps wanting to know why this picture right here that's on your paper, and this one's in color, okay, is called the Badlands. Well, look at it. Let me get rid of this so you can see it a little bit better.
It's a lot.
It's a little bit blurry still, but look at it. Why would you call that the Badlands?
Because don't look at it.
Yeah, it's rugged, right? Would you want to try to build a house there?
Yeah.
Well, it's dry and desert. Okay? Could you have a garden?
No.
Okay, so it says Lucy was found in the Badlands of Ethiopia. Above is a picture of that region. It's very dry, desolate. What does desolate mean?
Dry.
What does it mean? Nobody can live there. Yeah, there's nobody there. Okay, it's desolate and arid. What does that mean?
Badlands.
It's hot and arid. The wind's blowing. It's sandy and hot.
It's
just
hot.
Wet. Okay, so it's called the Badlands because it's bad land. Okay, you wouldn't want to try to live there. All right, let's move to number three. Right here, we're going to do it, then we're stopping. Okay, so work with me. We're doing number three, then we're stopping. All right, who wants to read me the next sentence? Okay, Wade, read the very next sentence.
The theme of Baylor's knowledge is found in a partial...
A partial what?
Oh, my gosh!
Are you going to say it? They discovered a partial skeleton of what?
A human ancestor.
There we go. Okay, so what's going to go on this blank? The team of paleontologists found a partial
skeleton.
Of a what?
Ancestor.
Human ancestor.
3.5 million years ago.
Who lived for how long?
3.2
million years ago. Yes, it is. Okay, how many of you are getting the hang of this? Okay, tomorrow when you come to class, you're going to fill out your planner first thing, and the second thing you're going to do is get this worksheet out, and you can work by yourself or with a pal to complete it. We are going to check it in class, and we are not going to take the entire class time to do it. Okay? All right, those of you in internet land, see you, bye.